Hi, I'm Jim Jubeck, and welcome to this week's Quick Pick video, Defiance Quantum ETF, ticker QTUM. There's a really great piece which I would urge you to read by Eric Savitz in last week's Barron's that makes a very strong case that quantum computing is coming in terms of revenue, probably like 5 to 10 years before it generates a lot of revenue. But certainly if you're looking for a big technology trend in the future, quantum computing is certainly one that I look at. It's a big, the ability to tunnel at quantum levels as below the below the level of size that we do in our current chips means that you can build big arrays and fast arrays. It makes a lot of sense to me. It makes a lot of sense to venture capitalists too. You've had 251 quantum startups that have raised $5.4 billion in venture capital since 2017, a lot of companies. Savitz's piece makes very clear that there are lots of different approaches to this, both big companies and small companies, and that we're certainly a long way away, in my opinion, from being able to pick winners and losers, which is why I'm recommending an ETF. If you want to get into this, Defiance Quantum ETF, QTUM is a good way to go. It's down about 26-27% for 2022 to date. That's much less than the technology sector as a whole, certainly much less than a lot of startups. And it's a relatively cheap ETF. Expense ratio is just 0.4%. It has about $100 million under in assets. One of the things that makes this kind of an interesting ETF is that it's got a lot of the stocks in the portfolio, the big stocks in the portfolio, the big positions are not necessarily startups. Top three positions are Infineon, which is a cheap chip maker, Honeywell, Texas Instruments. You don't get a pure quantum computing startup until number six with IonQ. IonQ. One of the things, if you look at the list of all these startups, that really jumps out at you is a lot of them raise their money through SPACs, special purpose acquisition companies. And that means they've been, A, hammered because everybody hates SPACs. They were the market's darling and now they're the market's dog. It also means that unlike a conventional IPO, where you have an investment bank or a series of investment banks supporting the stock, making you market in it after the IPO, SPACs don't have that. So very volatile, another reason to do an ETF. Here's a chart for that ETF. You notice that it's not been, this is a 6-month chart, so we're talking about, down. From the August rally through the bottom there, and we've come back up. I would expect that we're going to see this go down again in early 2023 as people decide they don't want risk in the market. So if you want a dollar cost average into it, I think that would be better than buying it all at once, or you can simply wait until it gets to be a more attractive point. I'm going to add this to my Millennium Portfolio on my paid Jubeck AM site, and that the sort of premise of that portfolio is that it's for people with really, really long time horizons, millennials. So 10 years, and the longer you hold something, the less it really matters whether you get in at the absolute bottom. So I think this is a good stock for that particular mindset. Okay, if you like this video, please like it, subscribe to my YouTube channel, that way you get notification when we do the next one. We're doing about 3 a week. You can get more of my stuff, 3 portfolios, not the Millennial Portfolio, on my free site, that's jubeckpicks.com. 6 portfolios, including the Millennial Portfolio and some ETFs and some options on my paid site, that's jubeckam.com. Thanks very much for watching. Find links to all those down below.